country of Ghana, where we lived in a camp with 40,000 other refugees. Life in camp was hard. Our father left. Our mother tried to find food for us. I always begged my mom to let me go to school, but it wasn't free and we couldn't pay. Finally, my mother gave me to an important big woman in camp who promised to send me to camp school. At the age of 7, I left my family's small tin house and moved in with the important lady. She had been rich back in Liberia, and I was happy to finally get a chance to learn. But my dream quickly became dark. Instead of sending me to school, she made me her servant. I was beaten and made to work long hours caring for her family. I learned to make fires, fetch water, scrub clothes, carry large cook pots full of hot food to sell on the road, and make money for the woman who forced me to call her mom. I was not allowed to be called Grace, only Dog. She told me I was a born slave. One day, I had the chance for freedom, and I took it. I gathered my courage and finally ran to someone to help me. By then, my mother had passed away, and I was 18 years old. For the first time in my life, I spoke out and told the world, no, I will not be a slave. I am not an outside child. I am Grace. I tell you this for one reason today. To ask that when you think about refugees and the lives they are forced into, please remember what put them there. Most refugee troubles begin with anger and guns and scared people and running. If we are talking of helping refugees, let us first talk of helping to keep people from becoming refugees. Somewhere today, there is a girl who has a home in a troubled land. Maybe she will lose her home and her mother and all she knows. But maybe if we focus on finding peace and removing guns from the hands of people who destroy life, maybe she will live in her home with her own mother as long as she